This is gonna be it. We're gonna get him right here. And we are gonna clear this stinking level. Sit through it, one shot, we got him. What is going on, guys? It is PowerBang. I want to thank Netmarble for sponsoring this episode of Lineage 2 Revolution. We have the real-time 3v3 team battles here in the Honorable Battlefield update. Super, super excited about this one, guys, because we've got PvP, which is my favorite, 3v3 in the real-time arena, which is about as cool as it gets on the mobile platform. So, guys, definitely take a look at the link in the description below if you're interested in Lineage 2. Going to have some gameplay here to follow. We've got more stuff that's new in this update, such as the Adina Vault getting a brand new difficulty level. It's one of my favorites. You get to slay a golden dragon. In addition to that, we've got Summoning Circle getting ratcheted up, and we've also got daily dungeons with a hell mode. Now we're going to take a look at that here in just a moment. So the Honorable Battlefield update will allow you to participate in the arena 3v3 every Monday, Wednesday, and Friday, depending on your region of the world. I'm Pacific time, so the America 2 region, we are at 10 p.m. Pacific each and every Monday and Wednesday and Friday. So I'll be back in the future. It is Thursday as of the time of this recording, so I'll make sure to grab some of this content and show it to you guys in a future episode, but let's hop right into it. All right, every day we get that free high-grade equipment. Let's go ahead and let's get something good. Come on, baby. Ooh, music sounds good, but it's just a light crossbow. That's okay. That's good fodder for me, as I can use that to actually combine and try to get myself a rare bow, which I can use to limit break my main weapon. We're going to normal dungeons here. Tower of Insolence, first and foremost. Well, we couldn't get it last time, guys. We have accidentally auto-cleared all the way up to... Oh, no. Oh, no. All right, so here's what's gonna happen. We're going in. And you guys remember last time we couldn't clear this? Well, we're gonna clear it this time, dang it. Let's go! Get wrecked! You missed, and it is on like Donkey Kong. We waste a shot there. We're just standing still, though, and doing work on this guy. All right, here we go. Keep coming. I'm gonna take a shot. We'll pop off the heels. Oh, no, we double healed. Taking shots right now for sure, just trying to do as much DPS as possible. I told you guys we'd come back and get this done. That is the goal right now, is to get it done. I'm saving the penetrating ability here right now. We're gonna save it for her. There we go, and back up one. And as she comes in, boom! Those succubi are getting absolutely wrecked. We need to sidestep this one. Ooh, and I do take a lot of damage there. Ekis here is a little fierce. Man, she hurts. If you actually stand in range and absorb those shots, that is okay though. New wave of monsters has appeared. We got Cena. I'm looking so much better on time this time than I did the last couple. 50%, we are still at, oh man. Using that last ability there. This is the hardest monster yet by far. I used that healing strike just so I could use it with a little bit of time left. I tried to time it so it's over a minute, so the cooldown has enough chance to run out. So here we go, we got a minute to take out the last boss. All abilities are up. Check this out, boys. Oh no, damage immunity. We save our missile bolt at least. How much time is gonna reset? There we go, 56 seconds. Okay, come on. Come on, let's go, 55, 54, 3, 2, 1. Oh my God, this is gonna be so close. Here we go, 22 seconds left. This is gonna be it. We're gonna get him right here. And we are gonna clear this stinking level. Sit through it, one shot, we got him. before he got off the big shot. That is going to be redemption. PB gets through the Tower of Insolence, and we're going to keep clearing on through it because, you know what, that was the harder tier. And look at that, we got some R jewelry. Let's actually go and open that up really quickly and see what we got for a reward. All right, so here it is. We head into the inventory. Ooh, we got that one-time deal. Okay, here it is. The R accessory box. We got the Nassan earrings, not too shabby. We can actually feed those in to level up our existing accessories. Not too bad, not too bad. As you can see, we did get a couple of achievements here. We'll go ahead and claim these. Wonder if it's gonna be enough to push us up to the next tier. I don't know if it will be. Not quite. We're 88% done with Wise Baron. So each one of these tiers that you complete, you actually get sweet stats from it. So I highly recommend trying to get all of those achievements taken out when you're playing in the game. So as part of this honorable battlefield update, we do have some changes that are coming to the existing tasks that are in the game, the dungeons. So check this out. Adina Vault has a very hard, and its recommended CP is literally 500,000 more than it was before. So I'm actually gonna head in right now. It says my CP's a little bit low, but we don't care. We're up for a challenge. Let's do this. We don't care. Cressius, let's go! Cressus! Let's go. Let's see how hard this really is. We're just gonna sidestep that. Waiting for the spawn of all his dogs. And we should see some dogs coming in right now. Or cougars or whatever the heck they are. There they are. We'll back up. I literally shot it the wrong way. I shot the treasure chest with it. This is horrible. All these hatchings. Hatchlings, I should say. No, 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 you ran in, you idiot. Why do you run in? Yeah, this is noticeably harder than before. So while he's doing his thing, I'm gonna put some damage out and go check for some other chests. Because remember, you gotta kind of bounce around and find the chests that are spawning. I don't know if more than one has spawned so far. Doesn't look like it. So we're gonna use our ability. 60%, under 60%. I don't think we're finishing this, man. There is the Adina treasure chest. We're gonna keep firing until that comes up, basically. Under 50%, where are these little cougar guys? The hatchlings. There they are. Ooh, get wrecked. There we go. Cressus is gonna, this is a huge golden dragon, man. We got a lot of Adina though. Look at how much Adina that is. Total is already up over 100,000. We still gotta have time to go around and get all these special chests open. Oh, knocked down. That did not help the cause. All right, more treasure chests have spawned. We gotta go up north to get them, it looks like. Maybe? Maybe? Yeah, there they are. Oh, they're both there. Oh, they take four shots now. So they've upgraded to four shots on these. Whoa. We are down to 5 seconds, or 5%. Let's see if there's any more. There is. Before we finish, we want to make sure you get all of these. 12 seconds, here we go. All of the abilities are popped. And here we go to finish off the beast. 1% Adina Vault complete with just the nick of time to spare. Even though we were a little bit underpowered as far as the CP goes, we still get over 200,000 Adina. So I'm really liking the changes to the Adina Vault. The 193,000 was my best mark from the previous. So now anytime I go in and I want to use one of my auto clears for the day, I can use that on the Adina Vault to max out that number that you get and make it super, super efficient. So highly recommend that as well. The next thing that's different is the summoning circle in this update. As you can see, there is a new very hard summoning circle Circle level that has added basically 71 levels to the previous max of 152. It is now 223 that you need to get into the Summoning Circle. Now, I don't have that kind of level just yet. It's going to take me a little bit to push up. But you can see right now that level 223 is your next Summoning Circle entrance. And check that out. Recommended CP is 812,000 CP, which is quite a lot. And you've got the high-grade Summoning Stone Fragment Box, as well as the extra-large Advancement Stone Box for a reward for that particular quest. One other new thing that we've got to try out for this Lineage 2 update is you guys see these modes that have been added. I thought Very Hard was going to be the maximum, right? Well, no. No, not right. Easy, normal, hard, very hard, and hell. Well, we'll see about that, Lineage 2. Let's go in and see what kind of hell you can provide us here. So here we go. Oh, that is nothing. We just knocked it down. Oh wait, hold on. We do have our soul shots on to try to take these guys out super fast. But that's it so far. We literally took out these guys pretty quickly, but it's all about, like, the boss. And, okay. You got wrecked. We'll pop that ability, and how many can we hit at the same time? So these guys aren't hitting me for super hard. Hell difficulty so far is not very hellacious. We are able to manage this. So if you're a strong character, you know, don't be too scared. Venture on in. But I'm gonna reserve judgment here until I see the very end, and we see what kind of monster we're actually dealing with at the end of this little instance here. So here we got some more skeletons down here. Pop some more abilities. Couple shots fire off. The Marauders firing the arrows. Oh, I'm done. I killed him. Oh, wrecked. Wrecked. Skeleton. Pursuer, he's done. What? All right, so this is it, moment of truth. We are flying in to the final encounter. We've got 3 minutes and 43 seconds to take him down. And who do we have? The Blood King. Look at that forehead, though. That's bigger than mine. Like, for real. I thought I had a big forehead. Apparently not. Yo, Blood King. Let's see. Okay, lots of Reapers. That's cool. Reapers are all down. Oh, no, I forgot my ability. No wonder it didn't do that much damage. We'll back up a little bit. Dude, that was a lot of damage. Blood King's at 27. Dude, we got this. No problem. Check this out. Pop a little heal here. We're going to mow our way through these Reapers. Boom. Just like that. Does he keep spawning Reapers? I think he does. Woo! Boom! Blood King! Take a seat, buddy. Take a seat. Look at that throne! He's just sitting on it. It's flying on a face stone mountain. I don't even know. I like how he died, though. He just kind of slumps down in his chair. Look at that! We got that Radiant Shard as a reward for the daily dungeon. And, you know what? Not bad. Not bad, PB. Anyways, digging the new content so far in Lineage 2 Revolution. Make sure you guys check out the link in the description below if you guys would like to play Lineage 2. I put a lot of hours into this game, and I can definitely say it is one of the best MMOs on mobile. So thank you to Netmarble for sponsoring the episode. This is Powerbang. I'll be back next week with you guys with another Lineage 2 episode. If you guys want to see more, keep it locked until then. Take care.